This video is recorded from my first YouTube live stream. Due to technical issues, video quality is poor and stutters frequently. I hope to fix this for future streams.
End of stream. No, I'm going to keep going for a few minutes more and just chat to people in the comments, so I'm not going to be building anything more from this point on. You get to just see this tank sitting here. Anyway, how about build tanks more flat? Problem with flat tanks is really the lack of internal payload space. Flat tanks is the lack of internal payload space, so yeah, no room to fit gear. Maybe I should actually go ahead and do that Discord thing someone asked ages and ages and ages ago, and I turned down because I'm just a really shy bugger. Maybe I should do that. I don't know. Anyway, yeah. Anything else anyone wants to say or ask about? Because that's when it's going to end. Basically, because right now I'm just here just to chat a little bit more for a few more minutes. Fit it outside. Yeah, the problem with that is that equipment outside the tank's main armour is more vulnerable to getting damaged. Or you wind up with really bulky, really heavy turrets because of how much armour you need to put onto them to protect them. So there's no happy medium, really. If you want to have stuff exposed externally on the hull, it's going to get damaged a lot more easily. If you want it inside, you need a bigger tank hull flat out. So that's what I've done here. That's why I've got so much internal payload space available for whatever. So that's what I've done with that. Okay, next question, please. Oh, I should also mention, that is my general opinions on things as well. I'm not saying this is absolutely the best or worst way to do it. I mean, yeah. You can build really flat, really small tanks, things like that, that don't really have much internal space, or just flat out Junker-style designs that actually have a lot of exposed parts. So there is that. Base is always a 40-meter ammo customizer, but that's the problem is cram turrets... killers. Cram turret killers? I'm guessing you mean cram shells fitted for kind of like siege operation, like massive shell go bang, blow everything up. 40 meter ammo customizer won't fit in this tank. It's not 40 meters long, sadly. This thing is 26 meters long, nose to tail. Protect turrets from crams. Well, the best thing actually is the most basic. Don't get hit by the cram. So cram shells are actually, by their nature, incredibly slow. So if you've got something that can be evasive, that's a good way to go about it. Failing that, a laser anti-munition system would be a good option, because cram shells are big if they've got any power behind them, so they are easy to detect. So that's a good way to stop it. But failing not getting hit and having something to intercept the incoming shell, your best bet is generally actually to have really, really thick defense. So in this case, really heavy armor plating. Metal armor, heavy armor, just something that can intercept the shell before it gets to anything you want to protect. Maybe spaced armor, because that's going to become more viable when that patch update hits. Like, you could have an outer layer, like... There was that talk quite a while ago about glass armour. So, let's just do this. Say you could have a layer out here, the shell hits here and detonates, and then there's this whole gap before it reaches the rest of it. So, really cheap throwaway armour, it'll intercept a few hits, but that's a way you can do it. The other option is shields. Shields are not very reliable against a cram cannon, flat out, because of how it works. So actual passive armor defense is your best bet. You could try You could try explosive reactive armor. That's really good against heat, but cram shells not so much, so that might help, but basically it's just it'll detonate anyway, so it's not really good. Anyway, shield protector. Here we go. Right. Basically, why has my graph disappeared? Oh, because the shield turned itself off because of that freaking ACB. Right, that's why the graph disappeared. Okay. Let's actually kill that ACB for the moment. Nope. Let me demonstrate things in peace. Right. So, yeah. I think I turned off the wrong ACB. F9. Look at me, I'm a professional. Turn the shields off. Oh, wait, it was because of the time delay. Right. There we go. That should stay. Okay. So yeah, internal armoring is the best. Shields, the problem is the low velocity of a cram shell. So as you can see, it's the entire thing with the shields. They get more effective as the velocity increases. So a cram shell just flat out really slow. So yeah, you really want to crank the shields up to maximum to give it any kind of effect. But also set it to reflective as well, that's more effective. But as you can see, even then, even with a 100 meters per second shell, which is by heavy cram shell, that is actually fairly sprightly, quite fast. But as you can see, it's very, very bad on the reflective probability. So multi-layer your shields, but even then shields are not reliable. So yeah, best structural defense for a cram shell. Pour on the armor, make it really, really thick to resist the effects, because that's all you can really try to do if it actually hits you. You've got to try and endure the cram shell. So yeah, other than that, I can't really offer much by way of advice for it, except, you know, angle the hell out of your armor as well, because if you can deflect the shell, that's a shell that's not to hit you, and a shell that has effectively done a little bit of kinetic damage, but then bounced off, and it's not going to do anything more. Unless it's got a angle fuse in it, in which case it'll just blow up anyway, and there's nothing you can do about it. But yeah, thick armor and angle it as best you can. Like, if I took a cram shell from head on in this, it's got a fair chance of actually bouncing off it on this forward plate. But from the sides, if it hits me in the sides, it's probably going to detonate. So yeah. Okay, next question. I'm going to cut off at the 2-hour mark, by the way, because why the hell not? So that gives you guys about another 3 minutes, if there's anything you want to ask about. I really need to get my stream settings sorted out. Yes, I really do. Armor unharmed. The thing is, even if a shell bounces off your armor, it still does a bit of kinetic damage, so you're still going to get scratched. Your paintwork's going to get messed up. So there's literally no way if the shell actually connects. Okay, your tanks are agile, close to mid-range brawlers, but they are flat, and one cram hit kills the turret. Do you mean the turret breaks off, or do you mean the turret actually detonates? If it detonates, then it is a case of your ammo magazines going up. I'm guessing you've got the ejectors pointing the correct way to spit the shells out somewhere else, so there is that. But if it flat up breaks off, then that means that the problem is the actual turret base block itself got hit. So that is actually the problem with really compact turrets. If something pierces the armor and hits the basic turret block, the entire turret just basically just snaps off and goes bye-bye. So that is one of the key vulnerabilities of a small turret. Even if you protect it decently with armor, if something knocks through and hits the actual turret piece, it'll fall off anyway. So small turrets, armoring can only go so far, unless you do something like this. No, this depends on having a thicker vehicle to mount it on. Let's see, new turret block here. One axis, because it's mounted there. And then, as you can see, because I've got it like this, the idea is that the ammo magazines and things are just inside, so it's an enclosed turret, and then firing piece and things will be up here. But, if you want a more solid design, with a, still a really small turret, if you have that, then you could consider using light blocks, actually. Just build light blocks up so that you can say that's a solid armor piece. Light blocks connect to a more distant turret base, and then you build the actual turret on top like that. So you'd have a solid layer of armor protecting your turret base block, but the rest of the system will be more vulnerable. So that's maybe something that can help? I don't really know, but I'm trying. Oh, there's another comment here. Can kill the exit in one shot. That becomes just a case of your tank is too light to withstand the incoming shell. So, if your tank is incredibly small, I would suggest a laser AMS system to do that. Because, in that case, protect it. Only way to protect it, well, to protect the light turret, I guess. Hang on. I think I've got some examples somewhere I can call up on quickly to check. Turret from the starting fortress? No. Auto cannons. Turret of. What's this? Oh, I guess that'll do. What did I even use this for? I forget. Oh, this is one from one of my old light, really light ships. I think this is one I put on the workshop, actually. Anyway. This thing has got very exposed systems, as you can see. It's a really compact turret, built just like this. And it just runs off the intakes feeding straight into the firing piece, so it doesn't actually have an ammo storage as such. It's really small. It's got some recoil absorption system, so yeah, it's got exposed mechanisms everywhere, but it's a really cheap turret. Really small turret, so that's one way you can do it. Just have it so cheap you don't care if you lose it, basically. So that's one way. Oh, that's from the cookie wagon. Nope, that's not going to fit on this tank. No way. Micro tank, heavy cannon. What's the... Oh, yeah, that's from the micro tank. So that's an example of a fully exposed one. So that has no protection whatsoever. Micro tank rocket, micro tank missiles, micro tank particle cannon. I still need to finish the micro tank, actually, now that I think about it. Torpedo turrets. Oh, yeah, this is a good example, actually. Do you remember the side turrets of the cookie wagon? That's this one. As you can see, it's got an armoured top piece there, but then the rest of it's supposed to be inside, so it uses the vehicle to protect it like that. What else do I have lying around here? Turret of the Scorpion 2 AAT. Yeah, that's a very heavily armoured, actually, laser turret there. It's very well protected, but it relies on a laser system inside the tank itself. So, that's something else. I forget the thing I'm not doing very good examples. What's this one? Oh yeah, that's the particle cannon from the hover tank I was working on. Right. BFAE-1. Oh yeah! This is from the ASB. Yeesh. I guess this is pretty darn exposed, so I guess it's an example of some sort, but it's a really heavy turret as well, so not good for a light tank. Turret of the Mantis, turret of something... Oh, hello, it's a different version of that, I see. Oh yeah, this is from that robot I made. Fully exposed pieces. What's that? Oh, never mind. There's another enclosed particle cannon. Alright. Spinner, ironclad turret. Oh yeah, I forgot about this one. Okay, so this might be an example. This is a fully enclosed turret designed for external mounting. The only exception is that it's got a few bits and pieces like the It's got an exposed sensor system installed. And it's got these gauge increases on top as well, but this is a cram turret, so... I get the feeling I'm not doing very well trying to answer this, to be quite honest. That's the feeling I get. Spoofing the aim point with ammo boxes, yeah, that might be an option as well, but the thing is, we're talking about a really, really small, really light tank, so... Not like that. Blind the enemy AI. The problem with that is if the AI has got good detection system, that's not going to work too well. Lasers. Laser. Let's see if I can knock up a okay laser defense system. You could try it with a beam, I suppose. Let's have a cavity. That plugs in. Right, okay. And add some pumps. Because I don't know if you remember that video way back when I was talking about compact lasers, but if you want a compact laser to really do much, it needs to be as many pumps as possible, basically. So yeah, this will do continuous damage, 1 AP. I think it needs a Q switch. I said that. So I forget where it is. I'm always losing track. This is why I don't like to record me building stuff. I lose track. Okay, so this one does 40 pulse damage. Really long range, yes, but remember laser damage drops off, and this is for an AMS system. And 1 AP. You need a couple of AP, though, because it's missiles. Because the missiles got updated and stuff like that, so... Let's put that, and then... Let's do this slightly better. Let's do... that. So it's got double the power. So yeah, that thing will now hit for 80, so that's actually really good for an AMS. And then let's add the main problem with it is actually its slow firing rate, so it needs to be accurate. You need to have good sensors to guide this thing. You need a flat laser system? Okay, a flat laser system, right. Well, how flat is flat? One block or two? Because I could just do it like this. Actually, let's do it like this. Yeah. Okay, the Q switches can go like this. So this will again be a one pulser. It's going to lack on pump, so it's going to lack staying power. Like that. Let's actually cancel all that out so it falls away. Right. So like that. So that's a really flat thing. That actually needs to go there. I could tear that out for an additional pump. Actually, let's install the Q switches on the front to make it a bit more compact. Then let's add in lasers. Let's add in a... No, not a combiner. I want cavities. Yeah, frequency doublers to give it a little bit of AP. It doesn't need much. It's only trying to deal with a laser. So yeah, that should do okay. Too high. That gives me a bit more space. But now I've worked out this really flat one high thing, so... There is that. Will that connect to it? That is actually connected, so I can do it that way and increase that as well. So this is very much a flat pack. Yeah. This is a flat pack laser generator, I guess. So that works, sort of. So that could work. This thing does a fair pulse and it's got fair sustainability, so it can maintain power. It's not going to do much in terms of raw damage, but it's going to keep pulsing. It's going to keep firing. So it's got that going for it, at least. It's also got fair armor piercing as well, so it should deal full damage to the laser when it actually connects to it. The question is, how much power can it actually maintain? Hang on. Let's install a fire control computer down here. So I can actually test this thing. There's no way to properly test the AMS laser, so... Next best thing actually has to be... you try firing it up. So that's the best way to do that. Laser combiner, put that out front. And then I don't care about any kind of accuracy, so just steering optics will be fine, because that gives me a better field of fire. So yeah, I can actually test this now. Okay. and then I can test how it works on under sustained fire. Because if you're working on a small laser, you want it to be sustained. You want to know how well it sustains its fire. Set the slots. Right. Yeah, it fires really slowly, but... Oh, I'm out of fuel. No wonder it's not working. Don't mind me. I am the best designer in the world. Yes. Jeez. I need to replace my fuel tanks to actually get some fuel back in. There we go. All fully fueled up. Right. Okay. Fuel's back. Because it used it all up because of the rotors. Anyway. 120. That actually sustains incredibly well. Intercept a full bison volley? Not really. The problem with a full bison volley is that it's like lots and lots and lots of missiles. So, yeah. What we have here is a flat pack pulse laser, which if you plugged it into an AMS system would consistently deal 120 damage to anything it hits with an AP of 7. So this is a really consistent hitting very small low powered laser. So it's enough for an anti-missile system, but it fires kind of slowly. How small flat engine can be to cold run a vehicle before steam kick up? Well, that depends on how much power does the vehicle need to run cold, and that depends on the vehicle itself. So there's no good answer to that. Generally, I think a good idea would be maybe aim for 1,000 horsepower on a fuel engine, something like that. So 1,000 horsepower, then that kicks in. And then when the steam engine comes up, you could actually program it to cut off the steam engine, actually, if you felt like doing that. Anyway, let's go to too high configuration up. With a too high, I can more reasonably fit in more Q switches and things, so... And I'll be able to fit more pumps in as well, so I can make a more compact design. At least in terms of how... It's flat cross-section. Its vertical cross-section is still going to be pretty bad. Right, yeah. Do it like that. Let's install more Q switches as well. So that'll be a 3Q design. So it's going to hit less per pulse, but it's going to fire a lot more quickly. A full 4 times more quickly. So that's going to help. But the problem is I need to have the armor piercing mods on the same Q switch setting. So it's going to be less piercing as well. That's the problem with having more Q switches. You actually need to have more... Actually, let's use that glitch. So that's connected as well. I don't know if they're going to fix this. I hope they do, because it's actually an exploit, flat out, but for a compact anti-missile system laser, it's probably a required one. That's looking okay. So, right. This thing... Actually, it recharges at the same rate. It can't store as much, so its pulses are less damaging. And that's okay. Multiple laser source. Yep. Really low damage though, that's its main issue, because it can't store as much, so a compact design this small is going to struggle for raw damage output without getting more storage pieces involved. So I would suggest, if you're going to go to something so small, a storage cavity is usually a really good idea. I need a laser connector now. Connector. Then a laser combiner again, so that can go there. Actually. Okay, yeah. You don't have to do it connected. I've connected it through the laser coupler. So that is actually connected, apparently. Okay. That's fine. Do that. And then I install a cavity. If you want to get the most out of a small laser system, especially a fast firing one, you do actually need storage space. That's almost as important as raw recharge. So you need to find a place to put that into it. So let's see how well this one does. It's a bit bulkier, and it's got that slightly bigger components in it as well, so that's not great. I'm sorry about that, but for the most part it is actually on the thickness that you asked for. So 35 pulse damage. Have I not hooked this up wrong? Is this not charging? I get the thing I've not connected it properly. Okay, that's kind of odd. Why is that not connected? It should be connected, but it's not connecting. So, yay, that's not working. Okay, let's do it slightly differently. Let's go ahead and install another one of these. Hey, might as well give it a bit more juice. Yep, how's that doing? 600. Damage 52. Should be able to sustain that, because lots of pumps. So, yep, rapid firing, 52 pulse. So, that'll take several hits to knock out a missile, but it fires fast enough to have a decent chance of hitting. So, that'll work. That will work for an AMS, kind of. So yeah, that's an AMS laser right there, built for two size, though it's kind of power hungry. Really weak laser. Should be enough to stop some missiles, so yeah. Anyway. Can you build a small flat fuel engine for demonstration? A two block wide one. Good. Do you want two block thick as well? Because you mentioned that in your design note. You said you wanted the 2 block thick. And this stream is just going on and on, isn't it? Wow. I told you I suck at ending streams. Oh well. I'm helping someone out, so I don't mind. Right. Just delete the laser. Because a 2 block thick... Sorry, 2 block wide... You can spare a 20 to 30 block line in your flat design. That is really long, actually. That's going to be a massive engine if you build it for low efficiency. But anyway, blocks, fuel engines. Fuel engines. Yep. Let's build one here. And one here. Any long engine, though, you're going to need a crankshaft. Basic part. 2 block wide. Can't really do much with it. So, let's do it like that. And then if I install cylinders, both of them I'll start off like that. And then it'll continue onwards, so do it like that. Yep. The main problem with a 2 block tall. Oh, hello there, Sporty! I was actually worried that you had disappeared from the channel, because I've not seen a comment from you in absolutely ages. Anyway, yes. I am trying to stream, but word of warning to you, since you've just joined. This stream is really not going well. My settings are completely messed up. And I actually, technically, I finished what I was trying to do like 20 minutes ago, but I'm still here and I'm just talking and demonstrating with people. So, yeah. I suck as much at ending streams as I do at ending videos, basically. Yeah. Anyway, two flat. The problem with a two wide flat engine is that you don't have anywhere for your exhaust to go, really, so it's always going to be quite low power. So if you want your engine to run with any kind of power system, you need to have your exhaust, but you don't have your exhaust, so let's go ahead and grab a junction pipe here. That's going to be the exhaust for those two, and then I'm just going to flat out install some injectors onto it, so... like that, so, yeah. That does that. Those engines will run without overheating, they'll run consistently, so this particular engine will produce 400 outputs in this configuration here. So that's a really small, too wide engine, but you can't really get away from the crankshafts, so yeah. I'm trying to stream because I thought I really need to have some FTD content kind of going on, but unfortunately insomnia is kicking really hard again right now, so I can't sleep, and I've wound up sleeping the entire day away. So I thought I'd try and streaming, and I'm actually enjoying it, despite the many, many problems. Let's see. Something you could do here, actually, if you're going to run it long, is you might as well have a carburetor instead, because that plugs into both sides of it. I don't believe that the injector does that. Let's quickly test that, actually, before I go going off half-cocked. 210, yeah. Injector only connects to one thing, but these guys, they connect to more things with the carburetor, so that's another 200 there, and you've got it slightly more compact, so I would say that is a good really flat engine if that's what you want to do for a really flat engine. Have injectors on the ends so you get the end cylinders being more powerful. And then you just go ahead and do it like that. So there you go. And this is enough exhaust to keep any of your cylinders from overheating. And that's a really flat engine there. Sleepers for the week. Yeah, I know. For exhaust, you mean your existing engine owner? Yeah, if you're going to go to do a really flat one here, two blocks, so like that, I would suggest. If you're going to do a more bulky engine like I was doing here, too thick, then you want to increase your ratio of cylinders like that. So you've got more cylinders here, you've got more stuff going on. And again, since you're being compact, you might as well use your... like that to keep it all from... Well, don't delete the blocks by accident like I do, because that is not very good. But you can do it like that. And then again, install injectors on the ends. Like so. So that'll work. So then you've got this entire section here configured like that. And then, again, you want to exhaust it. And this is going to be relatively simple to exhaust. In fact, if you want to do a four-block cross-section, you can do it this way, if I find the right piece. No, I want the four-way pipe. Yeah, that, like that. So you can actually run the entire thing along like this, and just have a unified exhaust system here. And this will keep the design cool, and then you can just install an exhaust somewhere outside the vehicle, so the entire thing can just be exhausting to a single point. So that's an advantage if you do it that way. If I just need a left junction piece like that. So yeah, you can do it like that if you want a four block cross section engine. And then if you want just a really flat one, you're more limited, but you can do it like that. So yeah, there you go. Some cross sections for small ones. Do radiators help? Yes, they do. That is another option. The thing with the radiators is they have limited effect, so if you really, really want a cool engine, you have to have a lot of them if you don't want to have exhaust. And they've also got to connect to your crankshaft as well, otherwise they don't get any kind of power whatsoever. Actually, do they connect that? Oh yeah, you can connect them off your cylinders as well, apparently. I need to double check this, hang on. Doesn't actually say, but yeah, apparently you can connect them straight onto your cylinders as well, so you can use that. And then they connect to each other if they are in the same flat plane as well, so I can put some there, and they'll work too. But the thing with the radiators is, that they decrease your fuel efficiency, so your engine is going to demand more fuel as it goes. So that's the thing. You could do that. Massive amount of radiators just along the side there for if you want to keep it super flat. So that would work. That's one way to do it. Or you could actually just... You could try foregoing exhausts entirely, I guess. Speak up. I've not changed the volume I'm speaking at, owner. So yeah, I don't know. I don't really know. It might be the stream acting up again, because, as you know, the stream has been really, really horrible. This might be an idea. Let's try it like this, and then just have a massive radiator bank on top of it. So yeah, this is a truly efficient engine. This. Yes. Okay. Let's actually go ahead and delete this example engine here. I get the feeling I've been left behind by the conversation, to be quite honest. let's go ahead and tear out the engine in here as well. Oh yeah, mirror mode put that block in. Remove that, remove the engine. Flipping mirror mode. Like that, yep. So that's... Okay, I've cut off my power systems except for this new engine. Let's see if it can actually stay cool. Let's speed it up and go. It's okay for power output. Right. Running along full throttle. 60 meters per second in this tank. So yeah. This is a... Yeah, so the point of the stream was to try and build a new tank for my own From Ashes campaign, and this is what I've worked out as an MBT for the Scarab. For the Scarab replacement. It can carry more equipment, and it's better armoured, and it's much, much faster. So, yeah. Okay, let's see. How hot is this actually running? This is actually running okay. 30 degrees. Yeah, these things are staying cool. This many radiators keeping it cool. It's burning a lot of fuel for that coolness, but it's running okay. Okay, let's strip off half of the radiators and see what that does to it, because if that works, how hot is it going to get? 40. Interesting. Okay. 50. From how it's slowing down, I don't think this configuration is actually going to overheat and blow itself up. So, yeah. Yeah, I'm liking this hull a lot, Sporty. I've taken a lot of design cues from the Mantis and how I was developing my building style and that, so I've got this thing. It needs 800 flat power to move, so it's a bit power intensive, but out of that it gets about 63-64 meters per second stable. And it's also got heli-blade based terrain hugging as well, so it can stay on the ground. Also, its forward armour is heavy armour reinforced, so it's really good. Primary weapon system? I don't know. That's why I said this stream was done, because I've developed it this way. So, it's all well and good. And I'm actually happy with it as it is now. So, the plan is to develop variants for it, like I did with the Scarab. So, I'll have missile type, a railgun type probably, maybe a particle cannon type. This thing could probably run a particle cannon pretty well. It's got plenty of space for power systems, so yeah, it could even fit a laser. This thing could actually carry a laser. Wow, I didn't actually think of that when I was building it, but it could totally carry a laser. That might be a route forward. Okay, let's increase the length of this because I want to copy all of that. Just grab that and put that in place. Okay, doubled up the engine, doubled up the power, and then open the throttle again. It should still stay cool. So, yeah. Yeah, well, okay. This is working. This is definitely working. Wow, thanks for the push, owner, because I've always relied on exhausts rather than radiators because of the efficiency factor, but if you're building a low efficiency fuel engine, you might as well go all out, because it seems you can actually get a decent one and just have it fully armoured and protected inside your hull. I mean, this four-block cross-section one is running at 2,775 power, and it's not overheating in any sense of the word, so, yeah. A laser shotgun tank. Laser shotgun tanks, they are kinda possible-ish, maybe. Yeah, that's why I said if you're going to submit names for this tank and colour scheme, because I asked for that, do it in comments rather than the actual stream chat, because I don't know if that hangs around or not. So, yeah. Okay. So, yeah, this is actually really... I'm going to have to look more into radiators. I mean, I've always considered myself a kind of an expert on fuel-fired engines. It's one of my specialties, but I've never used radiators for more than secondary cooling. Like, a little bit of extra cooling to try and keep the engine a little bit cooler, a little bit more efficient. I've never tried to run one without an exhaust installed. I think my 5K prefab is a good example of that. Okay, so 5K compact, this is as compact as I could get it using just exhaust systems. Though it has a cheeky little radiator mounted in the front there just because there's a bit of extra space. I'm going to have to rethink this prefab now that I've I've tried a different configuration. Oh, darn it. What engine am I trying to make? I'm not trying to build one, actually. I'm trying to respond to owner asking for really flat packed ones, like really flat design. Rams on your gun to make a lance. Yeah, you know what I was trying? I was thinking of doing a ramming based adventure run. And then I didn't do that because I couldn't get the drills to work properly. But yeah, this is my current power plant in this tank. 1,800 power. It's enough to run the shields and the movement systems all by itself. So, but yeah, I'm guessing that's the thing. But the thing is, though, Sporty, that was an exhaustless radiator engine that was just running my tank, and it was running just fine. So, yeah, it's definitely something that I need to poke around more with. But yeah, this is the basic power plant for this tank. And then there's all this space here to add in more power if I add a more power-intensive weapon system as well. So it's got plenty of space to be customised further, this hull. And that's one of the things I like about it. So, yeah. Anyway. Also, don't worry about getting sidetracked on things. That's been happening ever since I started just responding to questions and things rather than just finishing the stream. So... anyway, let's see. I'll get onto that in a second. I don't know what the stream has become, but it's become something else. Anyway, lasers. Sporty laser shotgun. I want to demonstrate this really quick because I said I have done a little bit of work on it. The only way I've found to make a laser shotgun is to actually mount up more laser combiners. Because no matter how you worked out... no matter how you work out having the lasers going into the individual laser combiner, things like that, as long as you've got a single combiner, it's going to give you a single laser beam. So, combiner laser beams, lots and lots of lasers, you need lots and lots of emitters to emit those beams. And that results in a fairly big turret for a laser shotgun. If you remember that laser defensive tower I built, I was actually planning to build that as a laser shotgun, but then I thought, I want a single, more accurate, more powerful beam, because individual laser beams, they're going to divide the power between them as well, so each individual laser less powerful, though they still have the same armor-piercing values. So that's basically how you do a laser shotgun, just mount on the laser emitters. So, yeah. Could work, though. Anyway. Yeah, this has turned into a demonstration, respond to questions kind of stream. And I don't know about this, but has the stream actually been stable for you guys since I stopped building? Because I've not seen anyone commenting about it going bad, and I've not seen it dipping into saying, nope, the stream's not available anymore. So, yeah. Anyway, something I should do before I continue, actually, is I should save this tank. I've been modifying this tank for demonstration, and I've not saved it, so... save this vehicle. V2 MBT prototype. And just save that. Okay. And grab a screenshot of it. There we go. Right. Okay, got that. Anyway, next up. Who won Sport of Combiners? The stream quality has been pretty good recently, so that means it was... it's something to do with the network, or maybe just my internet to this area. I don't know. Something's happened, but if it's going suddenly right, I do not know. Anyway, Disgruntled Perv, welcome to the stream. Sorry for not responding to your comment earlier. Let's see. Since I'm now looking at your comment back again... about a pack particle cannon. I believe it... What was the question? Hang on, I'm trying to find it again. Where was it? Plan using a steam turbines for a pack variant. A pack variant, yes. I would say steam is probably one of the best way to reliably do that. Stream is just lagging a bit for you, Sporty? Well, that is actually a massive improvement compared to previously. So, yeah. The thing is, I've not changed anything, so I don't know what's going on there. But yeah, pack variant. If you want to have a powerful pack, you want to have a decent recharge on your batteries, because it draws straight from your battery power. You also need batteries, so steam is a really good way to go about it, I think. Thanks, Forty, for pointing that out. Yeah, Wasn't there another one about building a flat pack? Use steam turbines for a pack variant? I think there was another question about pack as well. Owner asked about a flat build pack with 5 or 1 lenses operational. Well, the thing is, you can actually build a pack shotgun pretty easily. That's not too bad to do. Anyway, was there any other questions? I'm just scrolling back through the chat now. I think those were the only two. Yeah, I know, Owner. But the thing is, you can actually build a flat pack with multiple or single lenses. It's just that a flat pack is going to be 3 big. So, yep. Demonstrate a flat pack build with lenses. Okay, right. Demonstrate a flat pack. Flat pack. Actually, can't demonstrate a flat pack without demonstrating batteries. So let's actually just quickly whack some batteries into this space here so I can actually fire the thing, because that might be helpful. Just a little bit. Just press F. And cannot fill because... Oh yeah, because there's an empty block here. Right. Just turn that around. There we go. Okay, I have plenty of battery space now. And I'll configure the engine to give max power to batteries. So, battery charge, up to full. Off he goes. Give me power! Though really, yeah. Anyway. This tank can now hold 100,000 power charge, so that's actually massive. Anyway. Actually, Svorti, if you use all tubes, it will result in a 5x5 cross-section pack. But if you don't use all tubes, you can build a 3x5. Or if you build it with a single tube, it will be a 3x3. So it all depends, doesn't it? Really. So anyway, let's see. Where are these? Oh, yeah. Laser. Particle cannon. Installed a cannon! There we go. Particle cannon. I think I have a prefab, actually, which will work really well here. Where is it? Prefabs. Discovery parts, anti-missile cores, 150mm basic cannons. I know it's in some... What's that one? Oh, yeah. That's my weapon rig. Moving on. And yes, I still plan to do that, Svorti, by the way. It's just that I generally suck. What the hell is this? Oh yeah, that's from when I was doing that jet rig. Right. That's a fuel refinery. That's... I have too many prefabs. I need to clean this out at some point. I know I had a rig in here some... Ah, here we go. Right, this is a prefab I've got for building particle cannon coils. Yeah, 3x3 is not flat. Trying to work 2 dimensions. How much you would spend with ammo processors is not that bad if you're going with NG variants. Yeah. Plus there's the fact that stored resources is not explosive, while stored ammo is explosive. So there is a thing there, and I think I put this on backwards. Yes, I did. Yeah. That's one issue with this thing. I can't tell which way is which. I think that's the way. Okay. So I need to just scrap this off again. Okay. Actually, let's just scrap that entirely. Build a wooden block underneath so I can actually easily take the thing off in the future. Good idea. Particle cannon. On there. Place the prefab, which is that one. And I think that's the right way around this time. And I put it in the wrong place again. Go me. Third time's the charm. Third time is the charm. Dang it. Fourth time? I'm sorry, this is my building skills at their finest. I do this more often than you'd think. Far, far too often. Right. Connected! Finally! Right. So I could just do that, and that, and that. So, there we go. And then, of course, just tear out that last piece and put in a U-bend. Oh, there we go. Okay, and I suddenly have a pack cannon. Hooray! Single pack cannon. Okay, I seem to have messed up. Well, I seem to have missed a bit on the chat, so just a moment. Need to go back. 3x3 is not really flat. Yeah, it's cubish, I know, but still. Use all the roof space. Try 3 or 2 flat. Well, the problem is, of course, you've got this primary firing piece, so that's always going to be bigger. 20 to 10, 10 to 20. Oh, the reactor prefabs? Yeah, sorry about that. I've not managed to really add anything to that for some reason. I'm not sure why. For harvesting vehicles, I built a reactor building which was operational after about 3 minutes of work, but spent another 2 hours just trying to make it pretty. Yes, I know that feeling very, very much. Anyway, this is about as long as the entire roof, so that's fine. Single emitter. Okay, but what's it going to do? Initial damage 4,500, range 6 kilometers, 1,800 energy per shot. So this thing is actually really, really... yes, 40, it crashes all the time. It keeps crashing. Lenses that means no main... Wait, what? Lenses mean no main pack block. Use tentacles. Lenses are part of the pack, which... tubes. Wait, does that work? I know I need to... change the settings better. Anyway, back to this. So, you're the owner. You're saying that, just using a flat-out lens will work? Really? I did not know that. Let's try that. I am now very, very curious. Right. Packs. Laser pack. Let's see. Will this work? I actually really hope this does work. Laser particle tube. I don't think it will, though. That's the problem. Yeah, it's not working. It doesn't work because the problem is that the particle starts in the primary particle cannon block in this thing. So without this, you don't have a source for the particle in the first place, and that means that the main tubes are... you still need that main block, the main connection. So you had my hopes up for a moment there, but no, it doesn't work that way, unfortunately. So yeah, lens... that, yes, 40 is hits it exactly. That is how it works. Let's see, I need a straight tube here. Yeah. With the sub-lenses, as Sforty's saying, and, yep. This is my main issue with the pack tubes. They are not interchangeable, sadly, so... do it like that. Nope, hang on. Didn't I have a massive pack on something somewhere? I did. I remember having an absolutely flipping massive pack cannon on something or other. I forget what though. Height and length. Capture that. So yeah, if packs were like the exhausts have become, they would be a lot easier to manage. Height 3 and length just blargle. There we go. Grab that. And then I can just flip the entire thing over. And there we go. That's an additional tube. Right. And I'll set this up like that. And where's the emitter? The emitter. Here we go. Emitter. And then there we go. We suddenly have a flat pack which has 3 exhausts on it. So, yeah. One central powerful one and then a pair of smaller ones. So, So yeah, that will work. This is an hour treble thing. Not too bad. Let's check his stats. The two other arms are going to be weaker, of course. And you also can't individually configure the arms themselves, sadly. If you could, I would set one arm to EMP and then have the others do destructive damage, but that would probably be an overpowered weapon system, so that's probably why it's not. Anyway, 1 second. I've got an abundance of power, so let's go for higher overclocking, because that drastically increases power consumption. Set it to 4x. Charge time minimum. No. 1 second. Yeah, so those two subtubes do 3,600 damage each. The main tube does 18,000. Oh dear. I really need to get into packs more, because I've been looking at them of late, and it's like, I've never really given them that much of a serious look, but still. Where did all my power go? Have I messed up the settings? yeah, a couple of shots, that's gone. That's much more sustainable. I don't have the power system installed to actually do this. Okay, let's actually install a steam system really, really quickly. Steam engine, give me a large. Just give me a fucking large boiler, because unfortunately the steam system, what matters is how big and beefy you can make the actual steam system itself. So yeah, that's that. Okay, I need a 3-block space somewhere. That'll do. So I can install a small turbine. A small compact turbine. Which goes there and then goes straight into the small generator. That might be backwards, I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, I think that's backwards. There we go. Okay. So actually 2 blocks. Right, that's fine. This is going to be my steam. Then I'm going to install some. Actually, no. You know what? I'm not going to mess around with this. I'm not going to pack this thing full. So, yes, let's go ahead and do this then. And I'm in completely the wrong place. Let's just add in a small steam controller, because they are completely interchangeable. Full power burn. And a couple of resource blocks, of course, to fuel it. There we go, that's winding up to power. Okay. And then lastly, I just need to hook it in. So, steam piping. And again, these pipes, they work either way. And, oops, I'm suddenly venting steam straight into my face here. A nice steam bath. Yes. What a great way to be. Anyway, let's actually direct that where I want it. So, yep, that goes straight to there, goes straight to there. Anyway, yeah, that works fine. It's already generating a couple of thousand per second, so that in itself is just going to do it. So, here we go. And can't aim. Oh, yeah, hang on. Would have fast pointing the right way, wouldn't it? Yes, this way. Right. Hey, right. Actually, owner, it's more efficient. It's slightly more efficient to build the big ones rather than the small ones. Oh, look, it'll soon be a finished tank. Not really. This is actually a tank destroyer. Not a tank. The small boilers fill more quickly, but you get much more power out of the big ones. That's the thing. So, actually, it also depends on how much steam you're actually using from it as well. I mean, look, this thing is still climbing, and this thing is now generating 6,000 energy every second, and climbing higher and higher. A small turbine responds more rapidly to the steam and winds up more quickly, but it's slightly less energy efficient. So I've got a big one and stuff like that. If it is a tank destroyer, well, that's what he's in response to trooper Troopers comment, oh look, it'll soon be a finished tank, totally bamboozled into it. But yeah, this is a tank destroyer because it's got a fixed main cannon. To be a tank, I'd have to actually turret mount it, and I've not. This is just flat out built onto the chassis of the tank. So let's go over here. Over. Hello, little scarab, how are you? Are you okay? Yes, you're okay. That's good to hear because I've got something I want to quickly do. And now only the main one is firing. Oh, sorry. Oh, no. Oh, it's angle. It's firing angles. I see. Let's give it some horizontal focus then. Horizontal. I should let it turn a bit more rapidly. Yep, and suddenly it's firing a bit better. It's because of how close I am, so yeah, back up the way. Okay, that's fine. Right, let's mess up with this again. Let's see. And overclocking, I can overclock more. That's okay. Right, and give me some damage. I don't care about the accuracy. Why not? I'm just messing around with this at this point. Oh, jeez. Are we still talking about a pack? Yes, we are still talking about a pack. Unless you guys mean in the actual comments. It can rotate 90 degrees, use a different mantle? Particle cannons don't have mantles, so no. Oh yeah, that's the point, yeah. Can't actually see them when they're firing that fast. Yeah, too fast, too many, can't see him. Right, that's 0.25 hits? How's that one? Can I? Yeah, this is going well. One means max damage. Oh, damage, right. Field of fire max. Damage attenuation. Damage. I set them completely the wrong way. Please allow chat to contain web links? What? Yeah, pack doesn't have a mantle. What pack's equivalent is the field of fire setting here, which you can use to dictate how far it'll angle out of the emitter. So you can give it some, and then you can increase its accuracy in different variants here. Like this one is more accurate if you aim it horizontally than vertically. So that's how this one's been configured, but look at this! Ah! That scarab is not having a good time. At all. And then I'm actually powered out because I'm firing too quickly for my own good. But yeah. That was kind of effective, I think. It did something. Yeah. Anyway, I really do need to get this on this. General mantlet help. Wait, general mantlets? Just say H to the third dooby 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 dot a dooby 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 dot. Oh wait, you were speaking to Anna. Anyway, yeah, I'm getting confused. Automatically block spam messages, limit chat posts, no. Enable live chat, yes, I want that on for some strange reason. Is there any other settings I can mess around with? Participants. Hang on. Can't see anywhere to allow links. Yeah, can't see anywhere to allow links. So yeah, Anyway, that was me messing around with a pack. So, I've got a pack tank destroyer, basically, right now. So... Actually, it's a pack shotgun, for lack of a better term. Actually, if I change the charge time down... Was it the fact that it wasn't doing any damage? Yes, it was. Oop. Eat this! Yeah. Okay. I think that does something. Okay, anyway. Discord would be useful. Yeah. I still remember way back when I was asked if I'd do a Discord. I said no because I'm a really shy person, but it probably would be helpful if people actually do want to, you know, talk to me for whatever reason. Anyway, that's a pack. That's a pack. Let's go ahead and scrap that pack. Goodbye, pack. And it just slowly rolls off the tank. Get off me. Yeah. Okay, that's gone. Right. Yeah, the lag is strong with this one. It is. Needs better internet. My... I actually have fiber optic. So, yeah, I actually have good internet. I actually have fiber optic. So... I think it is bad settings. No. Right. Anyway. Do I still have that? Load of it. Oh, wait. No. I guess I am about to wrap this up, actually, because this has been going on for 3 hours now. Make magic, repair the stream, please. Also, Leroy Jenkins! Because someone said that. Leroy, hey. Yeah. This is my first ever YouTube stream. Kinda spur of the moment. Oh, people call me all kinds of stuff, H the Third. I don't really mind. I kind of gloss over it, really. I don't mind if people call me different things. So yeah, anyway. The last thing I want to do, actually, is there's a couple of things I might like to show you, if I can find them. Oh, well, that's one of them. Okay. Let's do it. This was an attempt at... yeah. This is a particle cannon. Functional particle cannon. A really small particle cannon. So, yeah, this is what I dubbed compact particle cannons. I've mentioned them a couple of times in passing, but way, way back. And I've never really managed to, you know, do much of anything with them. So, yeah. Yeah, I am hoping to... I am hoping to live stream more Disjunctled Perf, because I've been enjoying this and I've been getting into it, so... I think it would be a very good idea for me, and for getting more From the Depths content out on the channel, rather than just spending like hours and hours and hours behind the scenes, like, trying to do it, and then it's like, here, have this 10-minute video. That's, yeah, that's not fun. Anyway, yeah, this is a compact particle cannon. I was trying to work this out for a hover tank. So, it's really small. This exposed hub here is all that you can see on it. That's all that will be exposed. The rest of this is just going to be coiled away inside the tank. And then, so yeah, it'll just be this really small turret on the surface, and yeah. So yeah, it's built for really slow, but it really does hit things. Build flat, God-forbidden cram? What? Anyway, yeah, this was built as an anti-aircraft particle cannon, so it's really high accurate, really powerful shots, really slow. And the idea was that it's mounted sideways, so it's got these tiny little things mounted out the sides of the vehicle that hosts it. And they just angle up and like, ooh, aircraft! And then bang, hit it. So, yeah. Hello, Sean. Sorry, Sean. Sorry, I keep alternating that. How long am I going to be streaming? Not much longer, I'm afraid. I can feel myself running out of steam very quickly. So, this has been a case of I'm just talking with people now and demonstrating different facts and things. But I have told it to try to record on stream, and I've trying to record it on my system as well, so hopefully there'll be a video recording of it afterwards. The Tetris as a name for this tank. I don't know, maybe. Yeah, Tetris is a great game. I love playing that. And I do hope to get all the bugs out, as I said before. I'm looking back through chat to see if I've missed anything. The magic to repair the stream, I really do hope. But, I don't know. Name that song for 50 points. Sorry. I don't listen to music that much, and I don't tend to know the name, so... That's 50 points I will never get, and I am kind of sad now. That's no vehicles. I know I've got it in here somewhere. Go back. I've got too many tanks. Too many vehicles. Far too many vehicles. And, yeah, as you can see, I've got all these things. Archie power cores rig. Attack blast, attack nukes, things like that. I don't think I put it in there. Actually, where did I put it? Piranhas, flat spires, minnows, billpads. Oh, I've got so many things. Escorts, I've got a wanderer in there. Tide rippers. I never finished the tide ripper. Shame. It's a decent hull, that. I must finish it at some point. But then again, I say that about so many things. Generation 3? No, this is way back. Generation 3, this is... Oh yeah, the saucer. This dates back to my first ever From the Depths series. This is not what I'm looking for at all. Oh, the Reclamation Hub Fortress. Well, the version 2, anyway. Anyway. So much stuff. Don't spawn things, please. Might crash the stream again due to lag. The thing is... I keep saying this. My FPS is actually running at 60 to 70 FPS. Even when recording videos, I've never known it to run this good in FPS. So I know that my CPU is not the problem. Build a one block or two block nuke. Nope. And I know you guys are getting a much lower, so that's why I think it's the settings that's the problem. The audio, though, being really good. So any prototypes? I built this as a place for things that I started to build and never finish, and then I never finish them. So lots of temporary designs. The nuclear bomb, I remember that one. So yeah, I've got that. Monolith, was that it? That was it. The monolith. Right, okay, I'm going to spawn this in. Because since we're still talking about particle cannons, I figure I might as well show this thing. It's a thing. I never actually finished building this. 105,000 resources cost, and... Boop. It's basically the front deck of a ship with... a particle turret on it. Yeah, this is a particle cannon turret. So, Yeah, I was trying to build a ship out of this thing.
Listening.
Never actually fitted controls or chairs or anything to it, but yeah. Ping monitoring? Not really. Would probably be a good idea. Zion's left and finish is a sign of a true FTD player. I would agree with that very much. But yeah, I was trying to build a really big battleship, and I built, as part of that, a really big particle cannon. And this is a massive deck-mounted particle cannon turret. So, yep. Yeah. Game will crash? No. Actually, I know that my game is... My game can handle a lot more than this, so that's all okay. Yeah, it's a very odd one. It's very distinctive. It's got very flat surfaces, so it's not very good in terms of armor sloping and design, but I built this as I said, it's a flat deck-mounted gun. What is it? Sortie, I've been saying over and over, it's a particle cannon turret. Or let's actually press P here. A massive particle cannon turret. Massive. There are many, many, many particle tubes in here. This is actually five massive particle cannons strapped together to form a single turret. Please destroy the unused vehicles. Okay, sure. Might as well. Okay, let's go ahead and... I mean, I've saved that tank. That one's broken. That's just a structure, yeah. So... Actually, let's just go destroy all vehicles. Yes, bye-bye. So that's all gone. Right. And then I'll just load the monolith back in again. Zoom. So there we go. Bang. Right. So yeah, massive particle cannon, since we were talking about that. And since this is deck mounted, you can build a really big flat ship and then just whack this on the top anywhere. And that's kind of what I was going for here. Just something deck-mounted, leaving space for other things below the ship's surface. Now, the problem is, of course, this is a massive turret, so it's not really... It's not very sprightly. Let's put it this way. Fire control computer. Why can't I pull this? Oh, hang on. Main menu. Right. I'm in the wrong flipping mode for that. Definitely the wrong mode for that. Let's switch back to Netter. Because I need Netter for that thing. Because it's... I was building in the volume limited mode for Ashes of Empire because I was working on that tank. And that thing is way too big for that. So, yeah. Actually, Sporty, it does. I've seen shells bounce off incoming... Sorry, shells bounce off sloped armor many, many times. So sloped armor does work. Sort of. Anyway, vehicle designer. Yep, vehicle designer. Land designer, because I don't want to have things floating around. So, yep. Okay, here we go. This is actually a better place for designing land vehicles, I find, rather than the designer in the Ashes of Empire campaign, because you get all this sloped and hilly terrain around, so it's much better for testing the handling of a vehicle. But you can't build it with a volume limit. So, yeah. Anyway. Let's add that fire control system. It might take me a while if I try to power this thing up. I must point that out. So, yeah. Okay. Wait, there it is. Okay, right. As you see, this thing has four, and it turns really slowly. Yeah. That is as fast as it goes. But this thing is supposed to be an anti-battleship, anti-fortress kind of thing, so... It is very slow, but when it turns, it's going to pack a massive punch. So that's what this thing is meant to be, kind of. Well, as I said, yeah, using the vehicle designer in Netter is one I do find better. If you saw the videos when I was testing out the tactical nukes and things in my suicide units, this is where I was doing it, because you get all the hills just right there. So it's better for testing how vehicles perform. But yeah, that is just a massive pack cannon. Well, four massive pack cannons. What did I even set these things to? Let's see. These things... Wait, what? Did I build these things with extra arms? Did I forget? It's been ages since I've worked on this thing. Did I? Oh, yeah, that was messing up. I'm not sure which. Because it's saying the extra... Oh, wait, yeah, I remember. Right, I used extra arms on this, so it's got 250 one-way pipe returning to the accelerator. So yeah, basically this thing shoots out three particles per emitter. So this thing fires off 12 shots at once when it goes off. But because of its size, it's only got 1 second cycle time, using 5,000 per shot on two of them, and 2,160 on the third one. But even that, because of how big it is, it's a really efficient set of accelerators. So the weak one does 5,400, that's the central one, but then there's two of them which do 25,000 damage EMP in a single burst. So this thing is very nasty. How much should we use? 12,000... So, 46,000, 47,000 energy per second will let this thing fire, and it's nasty. Anyway, fast compared to your 120mm, 500mm APS turret. And that depends on the turret. I think, to be honest, Disgruntled Perv, that might be because you've got so much stuff mounted in the thing, or you've got a lot of armor, because weight affects turret rotation speed. So, yeah. Anyway. Am I missing anything in the chat now? I guess I should try and show you these things firing, shouldn't I? I don't know. Anyway. One. Yeah. As you can see, piercing. So this is another advantage of using multiple packs per turret. So this has got a pair of EMPs on either side. and then the two central ones are actually piercing, so it does multiple damage types as well. So this is a crazy pack cannon. If you guys are really interested, I could actually put this thing up on the workshop for you guys to mess around with, if you want that. Because, as you can see, I never quite finished this thing, and I've not tweaked it, but it's a pretty solid system overall. So, yeah, I could definitely put this thing up on the workshop if anyone wants that thing. But yeah, Steam! Give me the Steam. Large controller. Let's just whack a Steam engine into this really quick so I can get some power into it. Would help if I was in the right part, wouldn't it? Yeah, here we go. Right. Large boilers. All along there. Whee. Give it all that. Yep. That'll do. That's a massive steam engine, but given the size of the ship this thing's intended for, it's not really that bad. So you could easily fit something like this. I mean, look how small that is compared to the deck mounting of this particular thing. So, yeah, that'd be a thing. Build a flat cram. Yeah, but the thing is that I'm keeping a very close eye on time. And as I said, I am running out of steam. Ha! Steam! I'm building a steam engine right now. Fear my wittiness! Compact turbine. Yeah, might as well just build a compact turbine there. Then a compact generator there, so that's all you need. Because, honestly, turbines are kind of broken, to be quite honest. Because there's not much benefit of having a big turbine, so yeah. Do that, and the last thing it needs is some storage. That'll get the steam engine up. And that is the right way around. So yep, that's coming up to power, and that'll just build up energy, though that's the other thing I need. 50,000 storage of energy minimum. Right. Resources, give me a battery. If I'm just randomly whacking on batteries, I like to do it this way. Help if I was in the right place, though. Yep. Just put on a load of stuff like this. I don't care about this being a mess, so... Oops, I accidentally deleted something. Still don't care. Just keep on putting... Did something else, that don't care. As long as you got the outer ring fine, then just fuel command it. And there you go. Lots and lots of power storage. Woo! Bog means God in Russian? No, I didn't know that. I'm not very good with other languages, but anyway. Okay, that's massive steam power, massive power storage. It would still fit right underneath this laser, actually. So it would fit really easy underneath it. How much is that generating now? 8,000 and climbing. But I can fire this, so let's turn it around and... Yeah. Kind of a short range one, because I never got around to configuring these packs properly. Yeah, look at that. Lots and lots of destructive firepower going off. Turns, and starts to fire. Hello, people. And now it's actually tapping out of its power, so it's stopping. Anyway. You could make a really nasty pack with this if it was tuned further. Yes, Sporty, if you're going to post things, like I suggested with naming that tank I was building, it's better to do it on the comments on the YouTube finished recording kind of thing. Look, words, okay? Words. I can use words. I just choose not to because it is entertaining. Meaning this is deliberate. Yes, of course. Anyway, because the chat, we think it goes away. If you're going to do links and things, it's better to keep it to the comments rather than try to use the live stream chat. I mean, even if I had set up Discord, it would go away eventually because it only keeps so many messages on there. So yeah, okay. Right, I swear this will be the last thing I do in this stream. I swear it, honestly, yeah, definitely. Promise to God. Maybe. Oh, who am I kidding? I'm probably going to do something else. Actually, let's add some ammo storage. Let's block that off there. That's all blocked off, and cannot fill. Not see. Oh, there's a block there. Give me ammo. Yeah. I swear this will be the last thing. I'm 80% sure it's the last thing I'll do in the stream. Let's add in a two-axis turret. Give me a load of beams so I can probably control it. And then I'll do what Ono was asking about just a moment ago. So, what do you like your stream? Thank you. Honestly, this is brightening my mood no end doing this. But anyway, firing piece. Yep. A flat pack cram cannon. Question on the pack tubes. How vulnerable are they to high explosive anti-tank? Kinda. Individual pack tubes are not really that tough. They've got 100 health each and low armor. So they can be quite vulnerable to being destroyed. H to third, you're still not getting a stream? Oh, wait, there it is. Yeah, it keeps bopping in and out. So, yeah, it's like most other things. They are vulnerable, so you do want to protect them against an incoming heat round. Anyway, yeah. Flat pack cram. Owner, what kind of flat pack did you mean in a flat cram? What kind of dimensions were you thinking of? Because I know there's some things I want to add to this, but building a flat one, it depends on how big it can actually go. And I think the stream is about to crash again, because I was looking at it when it said, your video output is low. Flipping thing. Oh well. Yeah, I'm just waiting on that now. I might as well add a flipping barrel while I'm at it. Let's see. Since this is a two-dimensional, let's have some motor-driven. There we go. One long barrel. Right. Yeah, do you remember those patch notes, Sortie? Where it said that heat is actually going to be massively vulnerable to gaps in armour? Like, if a heat round hits a layer of armour and detonates and then hits a layer of air behind that, that air will count as an armour rating of 200. Too high, too wide. Too high, too wide. Okay. Let's have a look. Too high, too wide. That means I'm going to need the six ways. Actually, let's scrap that barrel immediately, because I had a thought. How long should I build this? 10 long, I guess? Maybe? Too high, too wide. 10 long. So I guess that'll do for now. And then that needs to connect to the firing piece, which can go there, I think. Yep. Okay. Now then, I need autoloaders. Manual orientation autoloaders. How? Okay, I need to get the maximum out of this thing in terms of autoloader links. That'll make the most effective cram. So, I need one to be... Looks like it's going to be flat like that. I guess. Will that do? Yeah, okay. And then, is that connected there? Yes, that is connected there, so I guess like that. That's going to leave some spare space though. But the thing is, it links to that, so that's a link there, and links there, but then it leaves a bunch of gaps along here, which aren't being of use for anything. So, what would happen if I did it like this? That would provide single links, but it would provide extra space for more stuff. So there's a bit of trade-off going on here, right? Large gauge, 132. Wait, hang on. Oh, you're talking about something else, Anna. Never mind. Okay. Air gap behind the shield will not be counted. The AC 400 will be counted for the first air gap after the heat jet exits the armor block. Yeah, that's what I said. And oh, it's 400, not 200. Okay. I kind of forgot that. Sorry. Anyway. Armor boxes are needed because of speed. So do this like that. Actually, might as well put one there. No. Yeah, this is me changing my mind, okay? This is what happens when I change my mind. I just tear down what I'm doing and then suddenly redo it all. So, yeah, okay, like that. Need that autoloader there still, so yeah, that's fine. Okay, and that'll be connected onto that, so that's fine there. Okay, that's all fine. Right, gauge increases. Let's install some of those. What's the gauge on that now? 395mm. Let's tear that loader out and get some more gauge there. What's the gauge now? 571mm. That's fair. Wait, what's bad, owner? Or is it just that I'm not able to follow the stream chat while doing this? Is that what's going on? Am I just completely losing the thread, or am I going even more insane than I usually am? Probably both, if I'm quite honest. Probably both. So yeah, I've got a bunch of ammo installed, which should help its cooldown. 3.5 seconds, that's actually way too much. I want to get... let's make this a high X shell. So, install high X rounds here. The individual loaders are not going to be super effective because they are... Wait, have I done this wrong? I suspect I have. Why can't I mount... Is that connected there? Yes. Okay, right. These ones are wrong. Okay, yep, that's fine. Right. And I can just do this long string of high X... fitting there. Right, okay. Sorry, from the OA to D. Yeah, you guys are just talking about your own thing now, not paying any attention to me. That's fine. That is absolutely 100% fine. Let's actually install that. Is that a good one? Sort of. Okay, so I've done that, so that means that can connect to there and then tear that out. So that's one block less. And that cram cannon is... Right, this thing fires every 3.4 seconds. Okay, it's 571mm. An unmodified, fully loaded shell will deal 3,795 blast. That's not too bad. That's not too bad at all. Get a bunch of FTD enthusiasts together in a single place and they just start talking about everything. So, yeah, I should have expected this, really. Anyway, doing that, still 571. Have I messed that up? Yes, I have. Okay. Right. So if I do it like that, then this thing has become a 940mm reloading every 7.939 seconds. Deals 9,000 explosive on impact. That's not too bad. Okay, let's keep that. And then let's go for motor-driven... Actually, no, I don't need motor-driven. Not on this. Add an inertial fuse. Okay, hang on. Add an inertial fuse. Inertial fuse... Where is it? Fusing box. Here we go. Add an inertial fuse. I need a place to put that. I guess... Here's going to do? Yeah, there. Inertial fuse. Explode an angle change. Angles. Doing that. So, the moment it deflects in any kind of way, it should just go bang. So, there you go. One fuse. That's dropped its caliber down to 873. It fires a little bit faster. It still does quite a bit of damage. So yeah, that's an initial fuse. Right, let's get on the barrel. Since this is on a two-axis turret, I don't need to bother with an elevation barrel. And I don't need to bother with motor-driven barrels either. No to a bomb shoot. Don't need flash suppression. Recoil suppression, this is a test cannon, so no, don't need that. All I need is just regular old barrels. So there we go. Now, what's that done to it? Shell velocity of 124 meters per second, so it's pretty sprightly. Accuracy 0.6, that's a bit low, so 0.52. Let's get down to 0.49, that's okay. It's not going to be a super long range cannon, this, but it's fair. Fairly accurate. So that's that. Okay. It's also pretty light as well. It just twists all over the place. Anyway, let's actually quickly do this so that I'm not controlling the particle cannon while I'm at it. So I'll set these guys to group one. Oops, wrong thing. Group one. There we go. Build. And that's my cannon. Okay, so what's it going to load up to? That's not too bad. Not too bad. If I'm reading this right, it's a bit slow firing, but it fires a 2,200 power explosive shell every 6 seconds or so. So that does okay. It's not too bad. It's not a flat-out howitzer. It's not a rapid-fire cannon. But it's pretty accurate, and it's pretty small. So, yeah, but that's not too bad. What else can I do to it, though? What if I reduced the caliber further and did that to it? Swap out the ammo internal stores for those on the better linked ammo blocks. Put in the ammo boxes on the less connected places, so it'll suffer from reload speed, but it's a smaller caliber, so it's going to fire more quickly. And it's got faster explosive pellet reloading going into it, so that's okay. Okay, its new firing speed is still 6 seconds. It's a 730mm shell. Maximum damage is about 5,400. So let's try it that way. Wait, what? You like it, owner? That's good. 132mm at most, though. Are you saying you want it on a smaller caliber? Is that what you're saying? Or is it, again, a case of the chat? So let's have a look. Yeah, it may be a smaller caliber, but it's firing a more powerful shell. And it's firing faster. Yeah, this thing does nearly 2,500 explosive damage every shot now. So yeah, that's actually a pretty nasty shell, though. In a fairly small cannon. So that's looking good. 132mm at most. I still don't know if that was directed at me or at someone else in the stream. Like, at all. So I might as well tune this thing down to 132mm, so just in case that was actually directed at me. Let's do that. Okay, let's get this thing loaded back in to that. Gauge is down to 485mm. Not cram APS. Oh, so you weren't talking to me with that. I see. Oh, well, I'm reconfiguring the cannon anyway, so Might as well just do that. What happens if I tear out these? What gauge will it be at then? It is now a 200mm shell. Which is actually not very good. It needs to be bigger than that. 200mm. So, yeah, I can't drop this thing down to 132mm. Because that's severely dropped its explosive potential. Crams are built more for heavy shells than light shells, so that's not good. Okay. Let's add in some more gauge increases again. Put those back. 300mm, 1,400, 2,300 is the peak with that. Fires every 4 seconds. Don't know. Let's see. Shell velocity is 116. Okay, let's try this one. See what it's done to it. Oops, need to forget. I'm messing the entire thing up. Anyway. It's definitely faster firing. The shells are half as strong though, so yeah, that configuration was not an improvement for the cannon. I'm going to reinstall that. And that one. So yeah, that mixed range one was working okay. And I think I get the feeling I'm talking to myself now. I really do. Oh well. 5.38 second reload. Might as well put in some more ammo storage. Get it below 5 seconds. Won't affect it much. 4.7 second reload. Actually, what about that? 4.57 seconds reloading. 652mm shells. 122m per second shell velocity. That's pretty good. I think this is a pretty nice cannon, actually. So. Okay, so what's your stats? 4, 5, 6, 7. 1,700 explosive per shell. Yeah, if you want crams to be more effective, you do need to use bigger calibers, quite honest. Self-talking is half the stream, but you always have random citizens here. Nah, I'll just keep on talking to myself and going slowly insane over here. Don't mind me. Oh, I've got a headache. Anyway, let's keep going. I think I do want to go back to the higher caliber shells. That's giving it a 6 second reload time. Let's tune it back again to the 7 second reload time. 7.35. 6.87. Okay, sure. 803mm. So yeah, that's. I think this is probably what I would do with this particular cannon, to be quite honest. It seems to be about where I'm trying to settle now. 5. Yep, we're back to that sweet spot. 2,700 damage per shell. 6.87 refire. 0.5 accuracy. Not such bad recoil, actually. So that's not too bad. And the shell's pretty healthy as well. An anti-munition system would have to do 608 damage to kill this shell. And the shell's fairly quick, too. So yeah, I'd say I'm happy with that cram, actually. I like that cram. Pretty fast firing, but it's a really simple system. It's really hamstrung, for the most part, by wanting it into a 2x2 cross-section. That's its main flaw. If I could build more freely, I'd be able to generate this kind of stats on the cannon in a smaller configuration, but it would be bigger, as in more of a block rather than a long thing like this. So yeah, there you go, owner. I hoped you liked that. So yeah, this is the cram cannon I tried to build out for you. I'm okay with that, definitely. And I just accidentally deleted something. Whoops. There we go, right. Oh, man. Okay. Yeah, I'm afraid I need to call it there, folks. Otherwise, I'm not going to have any videos out for tomorrow. So, that's why I put this stream up today, actually, because I was trying to... because of how late I slept, I couldn't do anything for today, so... Yeah, I need to go and do some other things now. So I'm afraid that's actually going to be the end of the stream now. So. Anyway, yeah. Thanks for watching, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. And thanks for helping me enjoy it. This has actually been kind of a blast to do. And it makes me want to stream some more in the future. Though I'll probably try not to let it overrun so much. To be quite honest. Show missile one. What? Fin, 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 fin. Fuel, 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 fuel. Frag, 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 frag. Short range thruster, radar guns. Yeah, that is a an agile long distance missile. Second half of the stream was much better. So you mean the part where I wasn't actually working on the tank prototype I was wanting to do for the whole stream? Sure, that's good. Glad to hear it. Yeah. Oh, well. See it on a regular vid. What, you mean the stream owner? Well, if you can see the stream as a regular video, I had YouTube set that way. Hopefully it should. And if not, I was recording system locally as well, so I might have that, but... the thing is, I turned that off partway through when trying to get the stream to behave, and then I turned it back on again, so... I don't know how much video there will be of this stream because of how erratic it's been. But I'm going to look into that and see if there is actually a coherent video I can put up to make sure that it's all still here. Yeah, I wasn't actually planning to turn this into a theory crafting stream, but that's just kind of what it turned into for the second half. Because I stopped building my tank like over an hour and a half ago, so, you know. It's been a thing. But yeah, anyway. Stream is about to go down now, so thanks for watching, everyone. And if I can, I will live stream in the future. But until then, you all take care of yourselves, okay? See you all later. Oh dear, this is a promising sign. My overlay is refusing to stop the stream. Well, that's an odd complaint. Well, I guess I'll have to tab out and do it manually. Okay. The power of technology.